Hi everyone, welcome to our presentation. Today I'm going to present our design project titled as DiaFit, Designing Customizable Wearables for Type 1 Diabetes Monitoring. I've worked with Roberto Mota and Dr. Somya Somunat together for this project. This is a co-design study that gathered design ideas and insights regarding customizable glucose monitors. We explored people's responses to customizing glucose monitors and prototyped DiaFit. It is a proof of concept toolkit that can help people with type 1 diabetes to build their own glucose monitor designs. The primary contribution of our work is in development and initial understanding of the design and acceptability of customizable glucose monitors. To address the challenges of using glucose monitors, we set our goals. One of them was to understand how adults with type 1 diabetes use their medical devices during various situational contexts. Because DiaFit was a customizable device, we wanted to better understand how users view the process of building their own glucose monitors and learn more about if people would like to even build such devices by themselves. To explore our goals, we took a three-part strategy: exploring, prototyping, and testing. We first conducted a brainstorming session with people who are diagnosed with type 1 diabetes and learned more about their challenges with the current glucose monitors. They developed ideas and sketches that addressed their concerns. Our discussion with them revealed three key design aspects that were important for them to be able to customize. They were portability, feedback, and privacy of use. With the light of the results, we designed and developed our working prototype, DiaFit. In the slides, you can see its modules and accessories. I'm going to share a video about how the DiaFit can be used and how the accessories and modules can function. The modules provide haptic, visual, and audio feedback about the glucose levels. Our prototype consists of multiple modular accessories that people can assemble together to build a monitor, which can be worn on the wrist, finger, ear, or neck. Lastly, we conducted evaluation session. Participants created configurations for each accessory. We wanted to learn which feedback modules the participants preferred to use with the accessories. They also selected accessories for various indoor and outdoor activities and social and private contexts. Our surveys showed that participants' preferences were varied. Participants also provided strong and weak points of DiaFit and suggestions for the future. We saw that physical environment and social situation and individual differences influence user choices. These differences result in different needs and expectations from devices. However, people are offered one-size-fits-all solutions. We thought customizing would be a solution for various user needs, especially adults who identified SF as makers were more interested in customizing and making more changes. We think customizable features such as having multi-sensorial feedback options, wearing them on different body parts, help to create inclusive products. DIY could make devices accessible and affordable. People don't need to wait for their products upgraded or even created. They can make even better devices. In the process, we had several limitations and challenges. For example, the size of the components also resulted in how the modules look. And we were aiming to find more participants, but because of the COVID-19, we lost our chance to meet with them. As a result, I can say that participants developed various design options using DiaFit, and they expressed an interest of participating in the design and development of health monitoring devices. Our early research showed that participants were enthusiastic about customization, and it's great. Going forward, we are interested in improving design of our toolkit. And please check our paper for more information and don't hesitate sending our questions. Thank you so much.